Steps ahead always. This is the motto of Dragon Models Limited, or DML. DML was established in Hong Kong in 1987 to manufacture plastic model kits for export to the global market. The kits are marketed under the label Dragon and are generally considered to be excellent high-quality products. DML's kits have won numerous awards from various sources throughout the world. Since its establishment, DML has enjoyed several advantages over smaller, less well-capitalized kit model companies in that it has consistently invested capital in new equipment and tools, keeping it out on the leading edge of kit model companies. As a result, they have released more than 1,000 items since 1987. Additionally, in recent years, DML's products have been marketed under the label Revell Monogram, or just Revell, in the United States, and Italeri in Europe. They have even been marketed by Hasegawa and GSI in Japan, and they currently have 65 kits being made exclusively for Cyber Hobby. These kinds of marketing and sales agreements are not new to the industry, and they allow quick access to markets under established names while allowing companies like Revell to expand their catalog at little expense. But these kinds of cross-pollinating deals are often somewhat short-lived. Since DML is now doing quite well under their own banner, the need to maintain these deals withers. But, that being said, there is cash to be made providing kits for other companies, provided you do not go into competition with your own product. DML has also had these kinds of deals with Testers, Platts, Academy Minicraft, and Kirin, as well as recently starting their own new in-house brand called Black Label. DML's catalog mostly covers military subjects ranging from the Second World War to today. Their first kits hit the market around 1988 and included mostly submarines, often sold in adversary pairs, and some popular aircraft such as the F-15 Eagle, the B-52 Stratofortress, and the Lockheed C-141 Starlifter. Following the success of these kits, they started adding more modern military equipment, both air, land, and sea. They made many of the popular aircraft of the time, such as the F-14s and F-16s, but also added some interesting kits such as Russian air cushion vehicles and United States Marine Corps amphibious landing forces. These kits are not as mainstream as other kits, such as the Hind helicopter that they made, but they were pretty much the only ones making them, so they kind of owned the market. DML makes its kits in the usual array of scales, 1/72, 1/48, 1/35, 1/144, and even some 1/200 kits, as well as 1/350 and 1/700 scale model ships. They also made a small number of kits in some unusual scales, such as a third scale guns, 1/6 and 1/9 scale figures, and even some small vehicles, and a one-off 1/10 scale Atom Boy animated character. It appears that around 1996 they started moving at least some of their production to mainland China and began the Shanghai Dragon label. This may have been done for simple cost-saving reasons or due to limitations on what could be produced in Hong Kong, but either way, it now represents a major part of their enterprise, although the company headquarters is still based in Hong Kong. In 1997, DML diversified into the pre-made model airliner field, manufacturing airliner models for promotional use and for collectors. The resulting Dragon Wings line of 1/400 scale aircraft has since grown to become one of DML's most successful and diverse series, representing over 100 different airlines as they continue to add new ones to this day. This is particularly profitable as the molds are recycled since there are only a small number of actual airframes to be made. They simply have to be put in different liveries. Dragon Wings has done such a good job with the airliner series that they were officially appointed as a supplier of aircraft models for both Airbus and Boeing for their promotional and souvenir models. In 1999, DML brought its modeling background and expertise to 1/6 scale, with the introduction of its new Generation Life Action series. By January of the following year, this series, which features fully posable military and licensed 12-inch figures with meticulously researched cloth uniforms, detailed weapons and equipment, was recognized as setting a new benchmark for high-quality collectible action figures, and they have about 400 different individual releases, with subjects ranging from World War II to modern-day special operations and law enforcement, as well as a few licensed characters and celebrities. DML continued to expand its catalog of collector-oriented figures, but the focus of this channel is plastic kit models, so I will emphasize that aspect. One range that sort of dovetails with kit models is the Action 18 series. These are 1 to 18 scale, fully posable action figures, which have turned out to be fairly popular with some modelers and diorama builders. You may have heard what some in the kit modeling world have referred to as the dawn of the new golden age of modeling. This started around 2005 as new techniques in mold cutting were allowing companies to make hyper-accurate molds. DML has been credited with inaugurating this new technique, and when they started issuing kits using this technology, they could be engineered down to the smallest detail, such as with their Imperial series, which was limited to just a few kits, but apparently represented some of the finest that were available, if not the finest that were available at the time. These are well-researched multimedia kits that often come with a great deal of metal and photo-etched parts. They are intended for the advanced modeler, and many modelers feel that they offer great value for the money. DML has continued to develop new technology, coupling it with innovative designs to maintain their market leadership. In a nutshell, they are willing to invest and to keep investing in their product lines. In 2006, they began a series of 1/6 scale figures and even later some vehicles. These did well, so they're still available. That being said, DML has also had their fair share of false starts. According to ScaleMates, at least 5 of their kits were never released, including the Jumbo Sherman tank in 2011. I've not been able to ascertain why the kits were shelved, but it may have simply been market saturation. Also in 2011, they began a series of real space vehicles with their introduction of a 1 to 72nd scale Apollo 10 kit. Now, these kits should not be confused with the pre-made Dragon Wings models. They gradually added to this line, including a series of Apollo 50th anniversary kits in 2019. In 2012, DML began a series of 1/9 scale superheroes and villains, starting with the Hulk, Iron Man, Thor, Nick Fury, Bane, Batman, and Hawkeye. This was followed up in 2013 with a Superman kit and an entire line of Iron Man suits and another Thor. In 2014, we got more Iron Man suits, the Hobbits, Thor Oakenshield, and Captain America, as well as Rocket, Groot, and Star-Lord from the Guardians of the Galaxy franchise. It appears from what I can tell that they do not do any kaiju kit models, at least not yet. DML kits come with nice decals, often from Cartograph of Italy, and many fine metal and photo-etched parts, but they can be frustrating to work with. So, by 2014, DML was marketing what they called smart kits, which still had a high level of detail, but reduced the amount of photo-etched parts, which reduced frustration and cost. They were also innovating with new kinds of tracks that required less cutting from runners, and in the case of their DS-100 or Dragon Styrene 100 tracks, they were one-piece tracks that used their own custom formula, mixing styrene and vinyl. Currently, DML's business scope includes plastic kit models, action figures, die-cast, collectibles, resin, PVC and vinyl, and some radio control products. But then again, the scope of this channel is kit models, so this presentation actually ended up being a little bit shorter than I expected, given Dragon's prolific nature on the modern kit model scene. Their biggest sector is without a doubt the 1/35 scale military kits, including figures. They have almost 600 kits in this field alone. Dragon claims that it sets the industry standards in many areas, and it is a market leader in many of its lines. Their older and out-of-production products are becoming collectibles, which is a testament to their product line. But perhaps the best testament to their products overall is their involvement in the infamous John Adam hoax. The what, you say? The John Adam hoax. This is the kind of thing that you simply could not make up. In 2005, a militant group calling themselves the Mujahideen Brigades posted a photograph depicting an American soldier named John Adam with his hands tied behind his back and a rifle pointed at him. His purported captors claimed that they would execute Adam if the United States did not comply with their demands, which called for the release of several Iraqi prisoners. Media sources almost immediately questioned the photo's legitimacy. Soon after, a spokesperson for Dragon noted that the man in the photo appeared to be their action figure, Special Ops Cody, and that the gun pointed at his head was actually an accessory that came with the toy. Not ironically, the toy had been manufactured exclusively for sale at the Armed Forces Exchanges in the Middle East. Once the news reported the story and the name of the toy was spread, they flew off the shelves. You really can't buy publicity like that. Well, folks, that's all I have for Dragon DML. I hope you've enjoyed this brief presentation, and as always, model on. Baby, if I made you mad, something I might have said. Please just forget my past. The future looks bright ahead. Well, yeah, I'll shoot around. It's all under 2-1-6. While the algae pie ran, my baby, while he ran, chandelier. Don't stop thinking alone. I don't want to make my feel this way.
It's my